We have with us this morning a former member of the United States Marine Corps, Sergeant Ron York. Good morning, Ron. How are you?
Great, thank you.
So you grew up in Statesville, North Carolina.
Yes,
you joined the Marine Corps after graduating high school in 1988, and then you became somebody responsible for making sure that our soldiers get paid. Is that fair to say?
Yes, sir.
Okay, explain that. I mean, when we think of soldier, we think of machine gun, or we think of, you know, barbed wire, but there is... I mean, those men and women need their paycheck. They need to make sure they've got money to take care of their issues, and that's something you were responsible for.
Yes, so the guys that were out there actually in the mud and in the dirt, they want to make sure their families are taken care of, so that's what I did.
You made sure they got paid.
Yes, sir.
What motivated you to want to become a Marine?
I really wanted to, I had a sense of duty, and I wanted to serve my country. I wanted to be able to travel, and definitely got to do that, and I wanted to have a chance to get an education. And the Marines allow me to do all three.
Okay, and from what I read, it appears to me you kind of worked yourself up. You know, there's seniority and ranking in the military, as there are in business and whatnot. I've always felt that somebody who obviously worked themselves up through the rankings up to a sergeant had there was not a lot of regret for becoming a Marine. I've talked to some people who joined the armed services and say, I don't regret doing it, but I probably would have chosen another path if I had to do it again. When I see someone who worked themselves up the rankings like you did, you feel like you made the right decision.
Yes.
Okay. Well, explain what helped me understand what you did to get the soldiers paid. I mean, because all I'm thinking about is bombs and missiles and grenades and, you know, and fighting and conflict and whatnot. But you had a different role in making sure their paychecks were timely.
Right. This is back before the internet and a lot of, you know, computers were not.
Direct deposit was not there, huh?
Well, it was in its infancy.
Okay, really?
So, but it was just mainly administrative work. Just it's hard to explain the way the Marine Corps pay as your active duty. You were always going to get paid unless something was put in there to adjust it. So we were basically tweaking the system to do that, but the reserves Marines were the exact opposite. So you actually had to manually put entries in there to get them paid.
I got you. One of the interesting things I read, you crossed the DMZ into North Korea. I don't know that I've ever met anybody that crossed the DMZ into North Korea. Explain that experience.
We were, I think it's Panmunjom, where the DMZ, the main little complex is at, and there's some buildings in the center, then the big line goes right down the middle, and we were able to go in that conference room and technically cross over the line into North Korea, and so I was technically in North Korea.
Was that kind of a weird feeling or not really?
It was, because you look right outside the door and you see the North Korean guards just, you know, right there watching you, and very...
I got you. Okay, so, I like to ask this. How is being a member of the Marine Corps made you a better parent, a better husband, a better your church going man, as I am? So explain how the military career made you better at the other walks of your life.
I'd say just the basics of discipline, you know, knowing how to accomplish a job, accomplish a mission. That was our main focus that you were taught in the Marines. So just those basic, just some basic disciplines.
Okay, last question. Weird question. Says you're married with two children, a dog, and 15 chickens. Help me with the chickens, man. What's up with the 15 chickens?
Well, once you get two, then you want four, and then you want six, and then it's a disease, and it keeps growing and growing and growing. It's just a hobby. So
are they egg laying chickens?
Yes. All hens, different color, blue eggs, brown eggs, dark eggs.
So not only are you a Marine, you're a chicken farmer.
Yes, sir.
Fair enough. We got some nice things. We want to say thank you, but Rev's going to tell you what some sponsors are willing to do.
We have a night stay at Hotel Florence, downtown Florence, dinner for two at Texas Roadhouse, a gift bag from Pepsi, some virtual golf at the 19th Green Indoor Golf Center, and a kayak rental from River Rant Rentals.
Okay. Thank you very much, Ron.